Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro here, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys how we can create buttons in Python, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Buttons. You click them, and then they do stuff. That's pretty much it. So this is how to create a button in Python. We'll need a window, window equals tk, followed by window.mainloop. Let's call our button just button, and in order to create this, we'll follow this with equals button. And within the constructor for this button, we're going to list what we want to add this button to. What is the master? The master is the window. And in order to display this button, we're going to follow this with button.pack. And we should have a small rectangular button within our window, but it doesn't display any text. Nor does it do anything, so let's add some text, and there is an option to do that. Within the constructor, we're going to list the option for text, and set this to whatever text you want to display. Let's say, click me, and then when we run this, our button now says the text that we set, and it says, click me. However, it currently doesn't do anything though. We need to set a command, that is another option. Command equals, and we list a function name. This is what's known as a callback. So let's create a function called click. And then outside of the window, let's define what our click function does. Def click, and let's print a message. You clicked the button. Now, with the command, we're going to list the function name without the parentheses. So make sure you're writing it as this and not that. This is what's known as a callback. So when we click on this button, it's going to perform our callback and perform whatever is within our function click, just like that. Let's customize the appearance of this button. I'm going to change the font. That is another option, font equals, and let's pick a professional font such as Comic Sans. It's very professional. And I'll set a size of 30. And now you can actually read what's on this button. It's large enough. Let's set the foreground color. That is the font color. FG. You can place a color name or a hex value here. I'll pick green. That is 00FF00. And our text should now be green, which it is. Let's also change the background color. That is BG. I will pick the color name of black. And now we have green text on a black background. Notice that when I click on this button or hold my mouse button down, the color scheme has changed. That's because there is a different active foreground and active background, and we can change those too so that this won't flash every time you click on the button. So let's change the active foreground and active background. Those are other options. Active foreground, and I'll set this to the same color as my foreground, which is green. So the text color is going to stay the same, and I'll also change the active background. And I will also set this to black to match my background. And then this should no longer flash when we click on our button. If you need to disable somebody from clicking on this button, there's an option to do so. And that option is the state option. And normally this is active, but you can set this to disabled, and we can no longer click on this button. And you can see that the color scheme has changed too. It's all grayed out and whatnot. So I'm going to replace this back with active because we still have a few more things to do. Now, how do we add an image to a button? There is an image option, and we set this equal to a photo image. But first, we need to create a photo image. I have this photo of a like button, a thumbs up that I want to use. I need to create a photo image from this image file. So within the window, let's call this photo image just photo. Photo equals photo image. Then I'm going to list the file path or the file name. Since this image is within my same project folder, I only have to list the file name. And this is called like.png, but if you use your own image, it's probably going to be named something else. Then I need to set the image equal to my photo image, which I named photo, but the photo replaces the text on this button, but it still works the same. So we would like to display some text as well as our image. We need to use the compound option. And we list a direction. We can list top, bottom, left, right. We want this image to be on the perhaps bottom. So let's list the bottom. And now when we run this, we have our text as well as our image. And if we changed compound to a different direction like top, then the image is going to be displayed on the top relative to the text. What if we wanted to count the amount of times that we clicked this button? We could create a variable called count, and we'll set this equal to 0. But in order for us to access this count variable within the function of click, we're going to list count as global so that this is a global variable. Every time we click this button, let's increment our variable count by 1 by saying count plus equals 1, and then we will print whatever the value of count is. So within a print statement, we'll just say count. Now, when we click on this button, we have access to our count variable that's outside of this function. And every time we click on this button, it's going to increase our count variable by 1. Well, everybody, that's the basics of creating buttons in Python. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of buttons in Python. Hey, you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.